Hi everyone, this is Nico71 and you are watching the design secret of this Lego Technic creation, which is an alternate model of the Lego Technic Set 42083 Bugatti Chiron, with the complete story and design process behind. Let's go! This race track features steering with steering wheel and hand of God, 8-speed DNR gearbox with controls inside and outside the cabin, suspension, openable element and tilted cabin. And yes, it has building instruction. Let's go for the model presentation. After creating my alternate model for the Lamborghini Chiron, I wanted to make another alternate for the supercar that I own, the Lego Technic Bugatti Chiron. I wanted at first to create another car with the parts, but considering the limited inventory and the two-tone color, it was hard to find a suitable model. The limited number of existing alternate builds for this set have proven that it is not easy to come up with a solution. So, as for my Chiron alternate model, I have made something different and built this racetrack inspired by the Mercedes tank pole. Again, it should be my first 1-to-8 alternate supercar, but it is in fact a 1-to-12 truck. So, here is the result, a 1-to-12 scale truck for 50 cm long, 21 cm wide, 23 cm 8 and weight 2 kg. The functions are quite standard, but with interesting design behind. First, the steering. It is operated by a rack and pinion through a bevel gearing connected to a hand of God located on the center of the chassis. I didn't want to put the hand of God on the top of the cabin to avoid the possible tilting of the model due to the overhand of the heavy cabin. The steering wheel is connected to the steering mechanism with a U-joint and gearing. It enables a quick disconnection when the cabin is tilted. The second function are the suspensions. The front suspension are double wishbone with two shock absorbers by side to compensate the heavy weight of the cabin. The rear suspension is a rigid axle with only two shock absorbers with more angled design to compensate the difference of weight between the front and the rear. The heart of the model is the gearbox. It is composed of a DNR selector which enables to choose between the drive, the well drive the gearbox which drive the fake engine, neutral and reverse. The wheel drive the fake engine directly counterclockwise. The gearbox is based on my previous 8 sequential gearbox from the 42115 Model B, the Ford pickup truck, where I have reworked the axle and the bushing and how it is built to reduce the friction and enable a smoother functioning, especially on the stepper mechanism. The controls of the gearbox are placed on each side of the hand of God on the center of the chassis. The left selector, the gray bin, is used to choose the mode between D, N and R, and the right selector is used to choose the speed. You can note that I use a small trick with connectors and colored axle to label the way each function works, with plus and minus sign, and color coded. Red on left side, plus is a drive, minus is a reverse, and yellow on the right side, plus is a upper speed and minus is a downer speed. I wanted to place the operating lever on the chassis for easy control compared to my Ford pickup truck, but I didn't want to have the cabin empty of controls. That is why I have used a linkage mechanism to connect each selector to the other control in the cabin. Like that, the two grain beams inside the cabin are also connected to the gearbox function. As the cabin can be tilted to reveal the mechanism and the detail engine, the cabin gearbox controls are fixed on the chassis to minimize the play in functioning. You can note also that I used a small bar to divide the space between the two gearbox controls inside the cabin, rather than used a beam or a connector to minimize the friction. Last function are about the openable element. As told before, the cabin can be tilted, but have also openable door which reveal the detailed interior with seat, dashboard, gearbox, control and fire extinguisher. The center of the chassis has also some openable elements to reveal the gearbox, the stepper mechanism or the gearbox lock mechanism. I find this feature is very interesting to understand how the gearbox works and avoid having to return the model to look underneath. Before talking about the design process, do not hesitate to subscribe to my channel if you like this kind of video, when I try to explain how I design my creation. As usual, when building an alternate model with specific inventory, I always start by the bodywork, to ensure that it is possible to build something good and recognizable. Therefore, I have started to build the front and the rear bumper, then the cabin, and finish with the side. It was not easy as the amount of colored part is limited and that it lacks some important part like azure or dark blue connectors. The idea was to compensate the lack of connector by choosing the correct orientation of the beam and the panel and fill the hole with other parts like teal and plate but also black part. Apart from some blue connector which are not very pretty to see, I find the result very good, with a plain cabin without strange color or construction but also a plain below bodywork with the bumper and the sides. Even if the bottom of the cabin is dark blue instead of azure blue, it remains the below bodywork and works fine in terms of visual appearance. When the prototype of the bodywork was finished, I have started to make a proper chassis, with front axle with steering and the rear axle, then connected with the 8-speed gearbox and add the cabin control linkage. Then, I put the bodywork of this raw chassis and start to look about how the chassis can be simplified or improved. So, I rework the chassis and then start to adding the detail. First with the fake engine, the rear and the front parts, and to finish with the interior of the cabin. Then, what I often do is to leave the finished creation on my desk for some day, in order I can test it and take a step back to look if everything works fine, looks good or can be improved. It is important to not rush on the creations. To talk more about this part of the design, I would like to introduce the flow or fluidic principle in design. It is a way to describe how aerodynamic or fluidic a design is, by talking about how the different elements are visually connected, how the different volumes are represented, and how they look homogeneous between them. It is linked to color and element choice, but also the proportion. For instance, a vehicle with broken line, strange volume, bad proportion, or strange color will do not look homogeneous. While a Jaguar Type E is, for instance, a masterpiece in design. For this model, I wanted to have a rising steel in terms of design. That is why it has a massive bumper, wider than the cabin, and I choose to have the rear wheel a bit higher than the front, to make the trunk plunging on the front. I have also created a sort of ascending line which goes from the front to the rear with the side panel used for the cabin, but also with a non-horizontal cabin roof with rear spoiler. Last trick about this design is to keep the homogeneity in the building. In Lego, it is made by choosing the correct orientation of the beam, the placement and the color of the panel, and cover the hole when it is not nice to see. For instance, the bottom of the bumper and side is black to enhance the perception of the other colored part, like the side or the above part of the bumper. It also minimizes the visible hole on the black part of the side. But this creation has also its limitation, mainly because of the restriction on the part. First, the model could be better in terms of styling by replacing the blue connector by azure or dark blue connector, or replace some colored axle which is too much visible. I would also appreciate to have more flexible parts like ribbed hose to create better exhaust, pipe and turbo, to have a more detailed and powerful looked engine. Regarding the functioning, I would like to have other suspension arms to have a different placement for the shock absorbers or put it one more on each side. Because when the cabin is tilted, the weight compresses the shock absorbers and the truck is plunging. It works fine when the cabin is in place, but I would have to have more stiffness on the front suspension. Also, more ball joint elements would have been interesting to create a proper live axle for the rear instead of a basic rigid axle. Despite this default, I found the design of this truck successful in terms of elements and color choice and homogeneity. Regarding the functioning, as the hand of guard and gearbox controls are on the chassis, it is easier to operate it. Combining with a visible mechanism and openable elements, it gives a didactic model to understand how the gearbox mechanism works. I like also the fact this alternate model is simply not a 1-to-8 supercar as everyone can expect. This is something unexpected from an original set like that, and at final, the part restriction fits this truck well. You can find all the details about this model on my website, which includes the pictures and the building instructions. As said before, if you own the Lego Technic Set Bugatti Chiron, you can build this race truck. Thank you for your attention. If you want to see the original video, please click on the recommended left video. I also put another interesting video if you are new on my channel. Please consider subscribing if you like my content. Take care, play well, bye.